Hi guys, my name is Itai. I'm from SupPlant, from Israel, and we came here to the beautiful Bosia in Bongoma to present our systems and work with the farmer. Generally, we have a very innovative system that the purpose of the system is to prevent stress from any plant. Okay? Preventing stress from plant means that it will maximize the growth and maximize the yield and eventually will save water. So what we did here in Bosia, we came to this beautiful maize plot belonging to this school and we are introducing our system and installing it. So I would like to go step by step and show you the parts of the system and how it works and how it connects all together and how eventually our models will give the recommendation to this field and will automatically imply water and irrigate the field according to the plant's needs, according to what we read and analyze from all the sensors that we have here in the plant, in the plot. So let's start and move to the water valve. So now we move to the beginning of the process. We have this unit here, the SupPlant Sapir system, that actually is like the center of all system. It gets all the information wireless through the antenna you see up there. It gets wireless from the stations and the sensors in the field, all coming here and broadcast to the cloud to analyze and be part of our model. When the instructions go down back to this unit, it is connected to this water valve and water valve and the water meter. So this is the water valve. It's an automatic water valve. It operates by itself. No one has to push anything. It just gets the command through the unit and open and closed according to the necessity of the crops, according to what the crops really needs. We have here next to it a very sophisticated new water meter that measures the amount of water applied to the field, and we know exactly when to start and when to stop, because there is the instruction comes with a millimeter of water, how much water this field needs to be irrigated. Once the sensor said that's enough, we got enough water, we are continuing the grass path, it will get the command stop the water, it will be closed automatically, and the plots will be continued monitored every 10 seconds with all the data we'll go to the plot. What else you need to know about this? So we have the main unit, we have the broadcasting unit, and it's connected to the main water line that is through the resource. There should be all the time available water there, because the system actually decides for itself when to irrigate. So it needs to be filled up all the time and let the pressure be to this valve be opened, and the water will be flowing to the actual plot. Now we'll move to the actual, let's say, the RTU, the remote unit that is connected to all the sensors. So let's go. Okay, so now we reached our plant unit. It's on this pole, and I'll explain the parts and bits of it. So as we said, it's all mobile. Remember, it's all Bluetooth connected and to the cloud. So we have this antenna here that actually broadcasts all the information to our main system that we talked about. We have this panel that actually gives the power to generate the activity here, and it catches the sign and fill up the battery also inside. What we have here, this is the plant unit. We call it the plant unit because it's connected to the actual plant. We are in a maize field. Currently the maize is very young, so nothing is connected to it, but I'll show you exactly what happens. As you remember, when we started talking, I was saying that our system prevents from the plant getting into any kind of stress condition. Okay, when a plant doesn't have enough water, when a plant doesn't have enough sun, when a plant doesn't have enough or good soil, it gets into stress. Stress means that it closes his symptoms and he stops the manufacturing of the plant. He stops the photosynthesis, he stops all the activity, he's consuming less water, he's getting into stress condition. In the worst case condition, even drops the fruits. So we want to prevent the plant from any kind of stress. So how would we know if the plant is in stress condition, yes or not? So we are connecting all sorts of sensors that will tell us the truth. So let's go and start and see. First of all, you don't see it, but here inside the ground, in two different depths, 15 and 13, there are two sensors which are soil moisture sensors. Those are two iron bolts that got into the soil and measure the amount of humidity in the soil. So we'll know exactly in two different heights how much water there is in every given moment in the soil, which is very important, and it's near the representative plant. What I mean by representative plant, you see that we have only one station here and there's another station over there. So only two stations, and it's enough because we are choosing a representative plant that will say this plant is an average of all the other plants in the fields. So we choose one and we implanted this system next to it, and once it will grow up, we'll connect the sensors to it. So now let's talk a bit about the sensors. What sensors do we have? First of all, and most important one, is it's the dendrometer. This is kind of a piston that is connected to the stem. Let's imagine that this is the stem of the maize. It's very close to it, and it pushes the stem a bit with this piston. Once the maize behaves like every other crop, it contracts and expands during the day. It goes in circles like that, okay? At daytime it contracts and nighttime it expands. So this kind of micromillimeter measurement gives us the data. This is really big movement. It moves microns, okay? It moves microns during the day. So it gives us the data of the expansion and constructions of the maize stem. It is very, very important because there is very high correlation between the behavior of the stem and the growth pattern of the maize and eventually the yield. So what would we expect to see at the data? We would expect to see kind of a sinusoid a pattern, but it must be in a growth pattern, meaning it will construct, and when it extracts, it will be higher than last from the day before, and this is why you can see the pattern of growth. If suddenly this pattern stops and there isn't growth, we must check whether there was a different problem. Maybe it was a very cloudy day, so there weren't enough sunlight. It doesn't mean that there is a problem. It doesn't mean that it stopped growing, and we want to know about it and try to deal with it. Okay, in later stage we're gonna have once the corn will grow and the actual corn the fruit will burst out, we will attach to them a fruit sensor. You see this fruit sensor, what it does, it grasps the fruit and measure it once again in microns the growth of every day. Okay, it's flexible and it's with this string here, and it's attached to it like this, if I'm the corn for that matter. Okay, I sit here like this, and every day I expand and contract, and I want to see the growth of the actual size of the corn along the season. And once again, I would expect to see it's growing and growing and becoming bigger. If it would stop growing, I would say something is wrong. Okay, when we take all this information, we take it into our models, but there's one important part missing, and we will go and take a look at it now. So we talked about the weather. Weather is crucial, no doubts about it. We need to know exactly what the weather would be and tell the farmers what's going to be in terms of weather conditions, in terms of extreme weather conditions, and let them prepare a few days in advance to what's going to happen. So if you remember this plot, we are collecting a lot of information in order to be able to supply later on the information to the farmers. So in order to understand, really, really understand what's going on in this plot with the corn, with the maize, we need to combine that with the weather, because everything is related to weather. What we're talking about weather, we're talking about perspiration, rain, we're talking about humidity, we're talking about solar radiation, and all of this is being measured in the weather station. So we set here a special dedicated weather station. You can see everything that I've talked about. As usual, we have this panel, solar panel, that gives power to the station. This part is a hole inside. It collects the water, the perspiration, and we know how much rain is actually falling down. We have a GPS station here that you can see it from there, but it's saying what is the exact location of this weather station, and we measure the radiation and the humidity in the air, and all together we have a very wide aspect of the weather conditions for this specific plot. Of course, when we are talking about smallholder farms, once again, we would not expect them to have a weather station. Okay, we talked about a solution that is sensorless. They don't have to install anything. So SupPlant solution has what we call the virtual weather station. There are suppliers that knows how to give weather forecasts all across the world, just based on your location. They've got their own models, their own satellites, and we connected to such a partner, and we have the best weather forecast that is not requiring this station. It's virtual, and the farmers in Kenya will get the best weather solution for their specific crops, and it will be merged into our recommendation. And I will sum it up. We're talking about irrigation recommendation for today, plus 4 days in ahead. We're talking about weather forecast, and we're talking about weather alerts. Protect your crops, protect your crops, be ready for the next extreme weather. So the purpose of what we're doing is actually to help all the smallholder farms in Kenya. We know that they are having very hard difficulties and challenges with growing maize and with water and with yield. So a small farmer in Kenya would not be able to afford such a system, of course, and we do not expect him to afford that. What we want to do is actually get the right data from Kenya, from the right varieties of Kenya, of maize and tomato in Bungoma, in order for us to get all this data and be able to recommend a good irrigation recommendation, weather alerts and weather forecast to the farm. And we hope that by the end of the season you will see great progress and great profits, should say, for the farmers and the families. Thank you.